First of all, we need to assess the work of the European Commission in implementing the COVID-19 vaccination plan together with other issues on the economic side and foreign policy. We must then assess the responsibility of the President of the European Commission when it comes to dealing with these issues. As of Monday morning, for example, 3.7 out of 100 people have been vaccinated in Germany, 3.6 out of 100 in Belgium, and 3.1 out of 100 people in France. Let us now compare the country that left the EU, UK, with a rate of 17.6 people per 100 people. What is 5 times more than the EU average? In the US, 11.7, and in Iceland, 5.1 people per 100 inhabitants have been vaccinated. In Israel, which is number one in the world, 63 people per 100 people have been vaccinated. The EU has often wanted to see itself as a powerful federation compared to other world powers. However, given this incompetence and confusion, it is an overregulated organism imbued with bureaucracy that is absolutely unable to deal with crisis. I've often heard how countries are unable to deal with the resolution of crisis on their own, and that is why we must all rely on the EU. The fact that the European Commission has been given a mandate to pursue vaccines will cause even greater economic damage to the member states. However, in the solve to economic crisis, the European Commission's ingenious solution is to take a huge joint debt, the real reason for which is the desire to move toward taxes across the EU. In this case, the question arises as to whether the European Commission is enjoying the ongoing crisis, as it is an excuse to offer a solution to the member states, which is the granting of even greater powers to the EU. Is it not a deliberately inflated panic, where people are being frightened by a virus that is killing everyone, even though we know today that the number of deaths is marginal compared to the total number of people infected? It is no secret that the European Parliament and the Commission are largely socialist formations, embodying an ideology in which the central government must guarantee unnatural equality and where the nation states should have nothing to moan about. To top it all off, the European Commission is also unable to cope with foreign policy, as evidenced by the High Representative of the Union for Foreign Affairs and Security Policy going to Moscow, making a fool of himself and allowing the Russian Foreign Minister to mock him, after which the President of the European Commission fails to make any comments. However, the Member States are being told that we are united. We'll have a common foreign policy, but our foreign policy will be dictated by Germany, France, and the Spanish socialist world, who has become detached from reality. And in this case, there is no other solution that the President of the Commission has to resign.